AFTV loose. We're through. Got to ask you, the starting lineup, a very, very surprising addition on the right-hand side. Mm-hmm. A young guy no one has heard of. What did you make of his performance?
Honestly, unreal. I'm just so excited about the future of Arsenal. I feel like, yes, maybe this season we might not win the Premier League. We might not get really far in any of the cup competitions. I'm hoping we do, but I think the long-term plan that Arteta is setting out is really promising. I'm really excited to see all these youth players, and I think he's definitely earned a spot, at least on the bench, for future Premier League games, 100%.
Yeah, I thought he was really exciting. And to be fair, going forward Arsenal today, there was a few performances that really impressed me. Emil Smith-Rowe, Reece Nelson, Eddie Nketiah, all of course deserve a mention. And I think what was really, really key was how positive the press was from the off.
100%. The thing is, that list could literally keep going on and on because everyone proved themselves. We knew everyone had to prove themselves going into it. Even Ramsdale with that save when it hit the bar, that is what you want to be seeing. And it does create that debate of who's going to start at the weekend. For me personally, I think whoever starts at the weekend will then start with City because you need that consistency. Mm-hmm. And I feel like Raya is better suited for that. But obviously, people could hate me out there because Ramsdale did put in a good shift today. I guess it's just what you get for having two great keepers. But no, everyone proved themselves today. Reece Nelson, probably player of the match, should be if he isn't. I feel like his getting back, it just showed we didn't give up. None of the players gave up, to be honest. And I think that's something that I'm really happy with. I find it quite refreshing as well, because if you saw the derby, that was not the same team. Definitely wasn't the same lineup. But I feel like we just came out fighting. So did Brentford, but we came out on top.
Listen, it was a strong Brentford side as well. It wasn't one like they played their reserves. But I wanted to mention the Aaron Ramsdale situation. Moving forward, what would you like to see happen there? Because is it a case of you just play who deserves to play? Or is it a case of you have your Premier League goalkeeper and your cup competition goalkeeper?
I would say, like what Charlene was saying, I feel like that would be better so they know where they stand. Because right now, they kind of just find out where they stand through the team, through Arteta's press conferences, which I don't feel like should be where you find out, oh, this is my first team keeper, like obviously Raya found out then. I think they do need to separate it. I would probably put Raya in the Premier League and Ramsdale in the Champions League, just because Ramsdale got us to that point. I feel like he deserves it. But it is harder if you want to keep that consistency. And they are Premier League footballers. They should be able to play every few games anyways. So there shouldn't be a question of fitness or their sharpness. But I definitely would divide the two.
Interesting decision from Mikel at the weekend against Bournemouth. Let's talk about us defensively tonight. Who impressed you there?
Tomiyasu. I feel like he made a few mistakes in the first half. I think all of our players did. Obviously, going further up the pitch, Jorginho did. But they all managed to pull it back. And even Kivior, like, saving, literally getting his body on, literally on the line, was mental to see. But it's so good to see that passion, that drive, that we actually want to do well. We want to be keeping clean sheets, makes it look good on Ramsdale as well, which obviously hassles Arteta with his decision. But it's just so good to see that. And I feel like the back four really came into themselves, considering these are 11 players that don't really play with each other week in, week out. The fluidity of passes, everything, it just worked really well, the chemistry.
Listen, Carabao Cup, a lot of people have divided opinion on it. A lot of people say it's a trophy I don't really respect or want to be in. Some people say, no, let's go for it. Where do you stand on this one?
Against Robbie, obviously, as you saw in the starting 11 show. But no, I do feel like it's silverware. Silverware, silverware. We need to be trying for it. But push comes to shove towards the end of the season, or towards the semi-finals, finals. If we are in a position where we have to pick, we're obviously going to prioritise the Champions League, the Premier League and the FA Cup even. But at this stage, I think we just need to be putting our all out there. As I said earlier, they're Premier League footballers. They should be fit enough and sharp enough to be playing a few games, a couple of games every week. So I don't really think there should be any excuses of just playing our subs, playing youth all the time. But it is promising to see our youth going through.
Any preference for our next round? We've got the draw coming up. So anyone you want or don't want?
Ooh, I don't know. Didn't Newcastle go through? I feel like that would be a good game as a neutral. For me, personally, I feel like that would be shocking to watch. Who else went through? Didn't West Ham? I feel like there's a lot of the...
Most Premier League sides now.
I was going to say, it's a lot of the Prems who kind of got rid of all the other teams. So I'm kind of happy to face any of them, because it's just, if we treat it as another Premier League game where, as we were saying, like Robbie was really emphasising earlier, we need those 3 points every week. If we treat it like that, we'd be calm against anyone.
Absolutely. Just lastly, going into this weekend, who are you going to start, Aaron Ramsdale or David Raya?
David Raya.